Thank you for what you have prepared. You say you prepared table before us, even in the presence of our enemies. And we know the devil is mad today. It doesn't matter to us. He's a liar anyhow. And we will receive the feast of the Lord today. Hallelujah. Your word will be rich in our lives today. We will grow in a powerful way. Permanent life change will take place in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. We're glad that you're here in the house of the Lord. Amen. We want to say hello to everyone on Periscope and on YouTube and wherever you're watching, everyone in the audience. And I wish you could be here with us. The presence of the Lord is in this house. God is everywhere. But sometimes we're not as sensitive to where God is and what he is doing. And we want to be sensitive to his presence and just trust and bless him today. This is a good day in the house of the Lord. Amen. This is a good day. Amen. We praise God for that. We are operating by force in 2017. And by that, it means that we are operating with the force of the kingdom of God suffered violence. And the violent take it by force. So we are in the standpoint. We're not begging for stuff. We're declaring things and walk into it. And that's what we'll be doing again today in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. It's going to happen. Amen. By the way, if you're watching on Periscope, go to our website, solfellowship.com. Go to SOL Fellowship and click on the notes page, and you will have the notes for the day. I put the answers in for you because I can't see you mark it in today. But just go to the notes page and put that in on solfellowship.com. You got it? Okay, make sure you go there. If somebody can put it up on Periscope, I just want to make sure you have it. solfellowship.com. And you click, you go there and just click on it. It's a bunch of categories. Go through the categories you need to go through and follow along with us. Amen? Amen. Let's get started today. Amen? I want to review some of the stuff we talked about last week. And we're talking about permanent life change and some other things that God is doing with us and for us. Permanent life change. The first one says, this is a review on last week, my capacity to receive from God depends on how I have thought about God, right? So we can limit God by the way we think. Our thoughts can limit what God wants to do in our lives. Amen? A good example is this guy named Jonah. You remember him? Yes. Jonah was upset by God, like your Afro brother. Jonah was upset by God. And in the process of Jonah being upset by God and the way he thought about God, he thought it was best to run. He actually thought you could run from God. Right. And how many of you know that's not true? Nope. Yeah. Amen. He could think that, but you can't make it happen, right? And he ran away from God, and he ran right into, became a dinner for somebody that day, right? Or right soon after, the whale swallowed him up, right? Amen. So anyway, so how I think about God can limit how I receive from God. So if you came today expecting to be blessed next week, then you would not be blessed today. If you came with, seriously, you came with low expectations because how you think about God depends on your capacity to receive from God. The second thing we talked about last week is what I think about builds my faith in either a good or bad direction. Faith works both ways. You got it? So the enemy, people have faith in what the devil is doing. Just as we have prophetic words, we have words of knowledge, right? The devil has words of knowledge, all right? They operate by faith. We operate by faith. And faith, now the devil's faith is based on fear. Our faith is based on what God has said and the love of God. But faith, what I think about will build my life in one way or the direction, either direction, so I can go this way or that way based on what I think about. If you want to know what you're going to be in the future, look at what comes out of your mouth now and what you think about now. Because what's coming out of your mouth now, what you think about now, is building your life for the future and is actually restricting your capacity for tomorrow based upon where you are stuck today. You got it? So number one, how I think about God will limit how much I receive. Anybody want to receive more?
Yes.
Then I need to think about God in a new way.
Amen.
And then what I think about will build my faith either a good or bad direction. This is just a review, stay with me. And then I make decisions. That's point number three. Hopefully you have your outline. I make decisions, what does it say? Based upon what has been planted. Did you get that? So the majority of what I am doing today is not based upon what I am doing today. The majority of what I'm doing today is based upon what has been planted in my subconscious, and I'm operating out of that today. So what the expressions I'm seeing on your faces, your body movement, your language and all of that, is going through my senses, right? And going into my brain, and my brain is then interpreting based on my past experience with those body movements and expressions. So you could be looking at me, and I'm trying to figure out what's going on with you, and you could be thinking deeply, but based on what has been planted in my subconscious, I could think that you're upset or don't understand. You could totally understand, but it's based upon what has already been planted in my subconscious. You got it?
Amen.
So now, I need to know, by the way, that stuff is being planted in my mind all the time. People study, design them. I'm telling you, we talked about how you go into the market. I'm telling you, those who study psychology, I'm telling you, if you go back and look at the guy who took psychology and decided that we can use it to get women to smoke cigarettes, look at the pattern that he used to move women into smoking cigarettes so people could make money off of them. He had to know how to do it and move them in a way they were not conscious of what was happening, right? Planted it in their mind. Now let me use an illustration I used last week of the tree. We talked about some plants. Now, did that kind of plant, by the way, Periscope again, I'm showing an area of some plants, little flowers, those small trees. They did not grow overnight. Anybody know what I'm talking about?
Yes.
It takes time to grow things, right? And I talked about how I can grow things in the right way by planting the right thing. Now let's say I want to grow something green and luscious like that, but I planted poison ivy. If I plant poison ivy, what's going to come up out of the ground?
Poison.
And more poison ivy, isn't that right?
Right.
Oh yeah, it's going to grow up out of the ground. So when I think on something negative, let's go to the other side. When I think on something negative, it's going to produce death in my life sooner or later. Mm-hmm. Oh yes, it is. And you can read the biology of it, the chemistry of it, amazing stuff. I'm not a scientist, can't walk you through all of it, but it's amazing how your brain will move and grow and what will happen and the poison that will take place. Matter of fact, when you start with the poisonous thoughts, the bad thoughts, you set up. She talked about in her literature how you set yourself up even for Alzheimer's because your body was not designed for that kind of stuff in your life. And so you can get that going. And we're wondering why we're seeing more and more of that today. It may be the diet, it may be stress, it may be all kind of other things, but it's also connected to what people think about. Mm-hmm. Amen. People's hearts are just poisonous thoughts pouring in, right?
Amen.
So if you get caught up in a sin problem and led away by your thoughts, it will lead you in something you're ashamed of. You can walk away over to the other side. Are you with me, media team? You can walk away over to the other side, right? And you can grow something wonderful like that, right? Or you can work on the other side and you can grow something like that. Now, how many of you want a bunch of dead stuff in your life? No, you don't. But that is what we're producing. And then we wake up one morning and say, what happened? You know what happened. You've been planting a bunch of dead poisonous things. Amen?
Amen?
And then we talked about if you ever end up with something like that, don't stay over there and say, oh, well, nobody is perfect, right? No, say, I walked into imperfection, and what am I going to choose to do? I'm going to walk back over into the perfection of God. I'm going to plant the kind of seeds that I want, the life that I want to have. Amen?
Amen?
And then saying this, you make a choice. So can I make a choice to produce death and destruction?
Yeah.
Yes, I can. Can I make a choice to produce life?
Yes.
Yes, I can. The Bible says choose life. Because a lot of us are choosing death. And we are upset when we have the harvest of what we have planted. All right? So that's a review. You got it?
Amen.
Amen. You got it? Come on, say amen. You got it? You understand that? Now, let's go a little deeper. You ready? Now, I'm going to make this statement. And then we're going to try to work through it. Here we go for today. What you decide, listen, walk it through with me. Use your brain, all that kind of stuff, right? What you decide to do now is not based, listen, not based on what you do now, but it's based on what has been planted in your mind over time. Let me say that again. In the present, you react to past memories. And you try to move toward, what you consider to be best for you and away from what you consider to be worse for you, but it is all influenced by what has already happened to you. And it's there lying below the surface. Anybody here with me?
Yes.
Come on, it's lying below the surface. Are you ready?
Yes.
I'm not going to put their picture up, but I want you to hear. Some of you will recognize. There's this famous couple that was in the news not long ago. You remember the family, right? The husband abused his wife. And what was interesting about this, he hit her on an elevator. And he knocked her out on the elevator. Knocked her out. Anybody, you saw that on the news, knocked her out on the elevator. He's a football player, right? I'm not going to put the picture. Knocked her out on the elevator. Follow me. You're with me? Watch what's going to happen. The woman he hit, stay with me, was his fiance when he knocked her out.
Amen.
Not long after that, she became his wife.
Amen.
Stay with me. So when he knocked her out on the elevator, she was his wife. I mean, a fiance.
Right.
Not long after that, she went from being the fiance to being the wife.
Amen.
And everybody was confused. They're wondering, why did she get up and walk away, stay with me, from the life of abuse? Remember, what I'm doing today is not based on the decisions I made today. They're based on stuff that's been planted in my life before today. Walking away is not easy. As you might think it is, listen, because when you decide today to walk away, everything now will be new to you, and because you're no longer being abused. And so now, if you really want to get confused, one, you got confused when you got hit. Now you're going to be confused when you're no longer getting hit. And then how you handle confusion will be based on what has been planted in your life over time. Based upon how you think about things. Are you all still there?
Yeah.
So there are physical challenges. Stay with me. I get to my point. There are physical challenges of getting away from an abuser. One, you got the safety issue, right? Because when the men and women know you're about to leave, that's when it really gets dangerous. You can't let them know you're about to leave. No, you can't. You gotta sneak out doing the laundry or something, amen. You gotta go walk the dog and never come back. Something, because if they know, right? It's the most dangerous time. But there are psychological reasons. There are reasons in your head. Are y'all still with me?
Yes.
There are things that take place in your mind that keep you locked in a bad situation. Listen about bad thoughts as abusers. Think about the unhealthy thoughts rolling through your mind as abusers that have been abusing you through life. And then you come up to a point where you want to change, but those thoughts are still rolling around in your mind abusing you. It's not so easy to get away from bad thoughts, because now you start to blame yourself for thinking that way. Come on, somebody say amen. Am I telling you the truth? You at least know somebody that had problems with that, amen? So the person being abused think that they are the reason why the person is abusing him. They're thinking there's something wrong with me because he knocked me out of the elevator. So it must be something wrong with me. Are you hearing me? Rather than that, the abuser is out of order. Come on, here's a shouting point somebody can make. Every unhealthy thought in my life is out of order. Can somebody say amen? Come on, every unhealthy thought in my life is out of order, and it must leave in the name of Jesus, amen?
Amen?
The problem is not you. The problem is with the thought that has learned how to live So everything you're trying to do dies. Are you hearing me?
Yes.
Come on, in the name of Jesus, we reject the thoughts of the enemy. Anybody with me? In the name of Jesus, I reject unhealthy thoughts. In the name of Jesus, I reject the thoughts that would allow the abuse to continue. In the name of Jesus, I say goodness and mercy shall follow me what? All the days of my life. And what will I end up producing? I will end up producing life. I will end up producing trees of righteousness. I will end up producing that which is right and best and good in the name of Jesus. Are y'all hearing me? I got a pathway out of the mess. Next slide. Go beyond the trees. Next slide. Here's another way to explain it. Think with me. Think of the change. Listen, of somebody struggling with a gambling addiction. Anybody know about gambling addiction? You don't have to stand up and confess, amen. But at least, have you ever been to a casino table? I know you walked by one, but have you ever stopped? I don't need you to witness, amen. Have you ever lost $100? No, you never lost $100. All right. Don't want to admit that. Have you ever lost? This is a true story. I was traveling with Richard. We were in Las Vegas for a concert he was about to do, and we were staying in a really nice plush place. And before his concert started, you know, we got everything free and meal and everything. I was there hanging around, and I walked through and ran into an old friend that I was in Oakwood College with years ago. Wow. And she was there in the casinos and walking around, and she said, "Bill, I never gambled, I never done anything like that." She said, "But Bill, I wanna try." I said, "You wanna try it? You never done it, I wanna try it." She got her little money out, man, and she tried it, got to pull that thing. She said, "Woo!" She said, "Bill, this is fun, this is fun. Oh, this is so exciting, this is fun." And went on, and after a while I said, "Now, you know, you gotta stop this." Because you get to, anybody know what I'm talking about? Y'all don't want to say amen to that. So you lost $100, but you won $45. Does it feel good to win? Oh man, nobody want to say amen to that. You lost more than that, you won. But doesn't it feel, anybody agree, it feels good to win?
Yes.
So if you start to think, listen, that if I can just keep on gambling, I will win more money and I will feel even better. Man, they act like that's not a true thought. You never thought that? Come on, some of you have been driving by looking at the Mega Millions. I know you've been lining up. I should drive by when the people line up, see if anybody remembers in that line. I go to pass, amen, looking up. Here's how it works. So you lose $10. Then you lose $20. Then you lose more dollars. Until you look up and you're down. Some people go down to their rent money. Yes, they do. They go down to their gas money. They go to their insurance money, all of their bill money. And you are thinking, somebody say thinking. You are thinking, somebody say thinking, that one more roll of the dice, one more card in my hand, one more pull of the lever, I'm going to win. And I feel so good when I win. And that good feeling of winning and all the money that I win will wipe out all of the pain of losing. And I'll be able to prove to people that I was right. And so you put everything, you're going to let it ride. Anybody know what I'm talking about? Okay, they don't understand that. Because you're going to win big. You know what I'm talking about? You take all of your winnings and rather than cash them in. And then what happens? You get down, man, you're going to let it ride. Right? Put everything on everything. You know, you scatter everybody. Y'all don't know what I'm talking about. All right. And so, somebody said no. And so, you get there, you got every base covered. You're going to make something off of everything, right? And you pull the lever, and guess what happens? You lose everything. Yeah, you bet it all on the man you met. Or you thought I was talking about gambling? I'm talking about your life. You bet it. You gave him your all, and he's gone. Amen. You put all of your love that you felt, I'm giving you my all, and now the love is gone, and the pain becomes so intense, and instead of experiencing the pain all over again, you try to live a different kind of life, but you still think the same way. Oh, somebody ought to say amen. If I had learned to think differently, I can make different choices. Amen, somebody. Amen. Are you hearing me? Is this making sense to you? Anybody here want to be free? Amen. I want to be free. Anybody want to be on God's winning streak? Hallelujah. We want to be there. Amen. So let's figure out, let's find out where you are. We're going to find out where you are. Do you have a pen and a pencil or ink pen or something to write with? Periscope, stay with me. We're going to find out where you are. Be honest with yourself. Look at your neighbor and say, be honest. Don't make me come over there and write your name in there. Are you ready? Don't make me come over there and write your name down. Amen. You got it? Okay, here we go. Here we go. Stay with me, Periscope. Here we go. How do I make the change? Let's figure out who you are. Okay, Matthew chapter 13. We're Matthew chapter 13. Periscope, I'm using the Message Bible, but you can use whatever Bible you like, all right? Version, Matthew chapter 13. And first, I'm going to look at verse number 19. Verse number 19. You ready? It says, when anyone hears. Now, can you cross out the anyone? And we're going to put your name in there. Just a test, just in case. When anyone hears good news of the kingdom and doesn't take it in, it just what everybody remains on the surface. And what will happen? The evil one comes along and plucks it right out of whose heart? Oh, you're going to put your name in there. This is the seed the farmer scatters on the road. Did you get that? Yes. I'm going to tell you about the listener in just a moment. But it says, anyway, when I hear good news, am I telling you good news today?
Yes.
But you don't take it in. Huh? It remains where?
On the
surface. And what does the enemy do?
Snatches
it right out of your heart. So two things. One is being scattered abroad. Secondly, the enemy comes to get you. Now get this. Sit up. I'm going to give you an answer in a minute. Sit up. Right now I'm preaching to you, right? Come on. I'm throwing words at you, right? Words are containers that have God's power and thought in it. It's anointed from God. I'm throwing it at you, right? I'm scattering information at you. I'm giving you images. I'm giving you ideas. I'm giving you thoughts. I'm giving you words. And you are taking in that information, or it's remaining where? You're doing something with that, or you're not doing anything with it, or you're letting it come in a little, and you're not letting it come in a lot. So listener number one, this is the person who builds a temporary memory. Come on, help me with the slides. This is the person who builds a what?
Temporary.
Yeah, some people in church, they're building a what?
Temporary.
Come on, look at your neighbor. Temporary memory. I've learned I do that with people's names. I meet them. I say, what is your name? My name is Jack. Okay, I'm moving on. Next time I meet them, what is your name? I'm putting it in my what?
Temporary.
Yeah, a temporary memory. What the pastor said, what I've been saying. Some of you your minds have been all over the place. If I started at the beginning with the paper in front of you, you don't even remember what you wrote down.
Wow.
If we didn't flash it up on the screen, you'd be like, Anybody know what I'm talking about?
Yes.
Look at your neighbor and say, Pastor Shaw talking about you today. Because I know he ain't talking. He don't have the nerve to talk about me. Yeah, nerve. To talk about me. Now, you ready? We got to get into this stuff. Amen. This is deep. You ready for this? I'm going to give you a clue.
Okay.
Figure you out. If you do nothing with the information within 24 to 48 hours, Sunday or Monday, then the temporary memory will be gone. All the words, all the strategies, all the ideas I shared with you during the message will be nothing in your life by Monday. It's like you never heard the message. Yeah. It's like you're not living it. You're not talking it. You're not praying it. You're not believing it. 24 to 48 hours, you're back to your old self. And you're wondering why it didn't work. If you're listening, but you're not doing anything different based on what you heard, you're going back to the same place. Here's another place where we can jump on and praise God. Because I say, praise God, that's not happening in my life no more. Yeah. The temporary memory process stops today.
Yeah. Amen.
Going beyond temporary memory. Anybody in agreement with me?
Yeah.
Amen. Yeah. Anybody here have temporary memory? Because
yeah.
You don't do the stuff that you're supposed to do. Now, all of us have temporary memory, but we got to go beyond that.
Yeah.
Huh?
Right.
Anybody here ever been stuck with that? You hear a sermon every day. Man, it's so interesting. I remember one time I preached a sermon about four or five times in a row. And somebody said, you know, just took the top of it and they said, man, I never heard you preach that. I could go back in my notes and show you. For the last 5 weeks, that's all I've been talking about.
Wow.
And I never heard that before. Excuse me. Listener number two, are you there?
Yes.
Look at verse number 20, 21. Come on, we got to get it. Jesus is coming again. You ready?
Yes.
2021. Stay with me, Periscope. The seed cast in the gravel, right? This is the person. You're going to put your name in there. This is who?
I'm not.
Yeah, this is you. Put your name in there. And what do? They hear. And what happens? They instantly respond with what, everybody? Woo! Thank God for the word, Pastor. Woo! I'm so happy today, right? But. Do you see that? Verse 21. There is what? No soil of
character.
Man, you gotta underline that word. You gotta have character. Are you hearing that? And so, it's gonna break it down for you. When the emotions wear off, and what's gonna happen? Some difficulty arrives, there is what, everybody? Wait a minute. Did you hear that? God, help me with time. Help me, help me, help me, help me, help me. Did you hear that? That if I start with something and end up with nothing, I might as well have started with
nothing.
There's no soil of character. This is the person. Who is this? Let's see if you're there. This is the person saying, I'm going to change. Woo! Thank the Lord, Pastor, preach that sermon, right? This is a person saying, I'm going to be different. A lot of excitement, a lot of passion. They're on fire. But when the emotions wear off. Anybody know the emotions wear off?
Yes.
Come on. When you come down from your spiritual high.
Yeah.
And you're no longer feeling excited. You no longer have a praise team behind you singing. And oh, man, oh, he's out. What a man. Oh, I'm with you, Lord. And nobody behind you singing, emotions wear off. That's when you're no longer feeling excited and you stop pushing through. Mm-hmm. Listener number two, emotions do what?
Wear off.
Put that up for me. Emotions wear off. Now, what has happened? The thrill is gone. Anybody know about BB's songs?
Yeah.
Huh? The thrill is gone. A lot of people with God, the thrill is gone. That's when, listen, the same pastor who's been preaching to you, the sermon is there, and now he's teaching you rather than trying to get you excited. He stops having you hop and jump and say, sit down and learn some wholesome. No, no. Who do you think he is? This situation is sad. Somebody say sad.
Sad.
Look at your neighbor and say sad.
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 Because listen, get this, please, please. Just like person number one, this person heard the word.
Yes.
Are you hearing me? They heard what they needed to hear in order to do what they needed to do.
Yes.
But they are the opposite of the woman who had the issue of blood. The woman with the issue of blood, she heard it, she made up her mind, and she took action based on what she heard.
Yes.
I've been hearing it, I've been making up my mind, and I'm saying I'm going to go, and when the road gets rough, I stop.
Right.
Are you there?
Yeah.
Anybody know about difficulties in life?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, it can get hard, amen?
Yeah.
It can get hard. So listener number one. What was the issue with listener number one? It was what, everybody? I know you got to look up because you got a temporary memory. What was the issue with listener number one? It was what?
Temporary.
Yeah, and how long did they last? 28 to what? 24 to what? And they were gone. Listener number two, get this. They hung on about 4 days, maybe 5 days, maybe 7 days. They were exercising and eating the right food for 7 days. Anybody know about that? The right amount of food for 7 days. Eating at the right time for 7 days. Fixing their lunch for 7 days. Drinking water for 7 days. Saving their money for 7 days. And whatever your struggle is, for 7 days. I'm saying no to that thing for 7 days. And then after the 7 days, the urge comes back. The thrill is gone. And now I got to deal with what I'm feeling now after the 7 days. And what do they do after the 7 days? It's as if nothing has happened. Are you hearing me? Man, you want to make it with God, you got to get past the 24, 48 hours. You got to get past the 7 days, and you got to press on with God. Which listener are you? Which listener? Be honest with yourself. Which listener are you? After a few days, do you know the emotions? And do you know couples go through this? In a honeymoon, man, you're just, oh man, everything he does, everything she does. She can get up in the morning and belch. You're like, oh baby, I just love it, amen? But after, anybody know what I'm talking about? After, you're like, why are you making those sounds? I've been making those sounds ever since you've been dating me. It used to be cute. Come on, somebody look at your neighbor and say, he's telling the truth, y'all. Tell the truth. Don't get mad with the pastor today. Yeah. Listen, when my emotions are gone, guess what I'm supposed to do? That's when I start walking by faith.
Yes.
Are you hearing me? Because God is testing somebody today. I know he's testing me. He's testing me to teach me. Are you going to walk by sight or are you going to walk by faith? I'd rather walk by faith rather than get caught up again in the cycle of sight. Not fired up anymore. I'm not feeling you anymore. You ever say to somebody, I'm not feeling you anymore? I used to be feeling you. Man, Hollywood does that all the time. Man, there's some couples in Hollywood get married. I say, yeah, man, they're going to make pretty babies. You know what I'm talking about? Y'all don't ever do that? They're going to make pretty babies, a power couple. And then all of a sudden they say, well, I'm not feeling you anymore. So he's been on a new movie and he's feeling the new one.
Right.
And forget, she's acting too. Anyway, let me move on. You lost that loving feeling. What did Elvis say? Now it's gone, gone, gone. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Anybody know what I'm talking about? So now I got to draw on my faith, right? Faith is the evidence of a substance. Something that is not seen, but I have evidence. I got substance. Faith is my obedient response to something God said, even though I'm no longer excited about what God said. Are y'all hearing me? And the Bible said, without faith, it is what? Impossible to please who? So when you stop feeling good about serving God, guess what you do? You stop serving God. When you stop feeling good about going to church, guess what you do? Oh, I'm not feeling it. 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 So did they change or did you change? I'm not getting anything out of church. I'm no longer getting the goosebumps. Anybody had the goosebumps? Y'all never had it? Man, I've had the power of God come on me, and I felt God move, and I would swear God was at work. And then there have been times when I felt nothing, and God was moving so powerful. I got home, I said, baby, nobody enjoyed the sermon, nobody got blessed. She said, what, where were you? People were getting blessed, people were getting healed, I felt nothing, and because I didn't feel it, God wasn't there. Wow, anybody know what I'm talking about? Yes. So that I don't feel like coming to church today. I don't feel like getting up in the morning. I don't feel like praying. I don't feel like reading my Bible. And because I don't feel it, I stop doing it. And I end up with nothing. Is that what your Bible said or mine? Huh? Come on, are you all in the room? Did it say that in your Bible?
Yes.
Yeah, no more goosebumps. Which listener are you? Let's go to listener number three. They say, move on, Pastor. It's getting rough. Huh? Matthew 13:22. You ready for verse 22?
Yes.
Come on, are you getting this? I'm going to find you. Somebody say, Pastor, find me. I already found you. But I'm going to give you the solution, amen? I found me up in here. Verse number 22. The seed cast in the what? Wait. So they've been smoking for a long time. Anyway, the seed cast in the weed is the person who what? Hears. Are they hearing? But what happens? Weeds of worry and illusions. Come on, y'all. About getting more and wanting everything under the sun. What does it do?
Strangles
what is being heard. And what is the end result? Come on, what is the end result? So listener number one, what was the issue? They had a what? They had a temporary. Listener number two, what was the issue? Huh? Yeah. Listener number three, they go further than listener one and two. But the worries are here. Worry and envy comes up. Anybody know about envy? Yeah, instead of keeping your mind on your direction and planning good thoughts, you have unhealthy thoughts, and you all in somebody else's business. Sweep around your own front door if you want your front door to be clean.
Yes. Amen.
Beauty strangled out of your life. That's why you got to keep pushing the things of God. So you see somebody doing better than you, and they get a promotion on the job, and you get nothing, and you become envious. Rather than going up to them and say, how did you do that? Come on, somebody know what I'm talking about? Somebody gets married and you get nothing, and you become envious. Rather than going up to them and say, how'd you do that? Come on, somebody. Don't be a mess. You ain't got nobody anyway. You might as well learn how to get... Come on, am I being real with you? Some people know how to get somebody and put them in place. You don't even know how to catch a fly. You ought to learn from... Come on, that wasn't my notes, but it just slipped out, amen? You know what I'm talking about? You better learn. Are you listening to me? When I done learned, know how to talk to women, I got next to somebody and said, show me how to talk to them. I get too nervous. I start talking fast. He said, no, slow your roll. Show your roll. Stay here for a while. Just lean. Uh-oh. Said, what are you talking? Slow down. He don't show. And I'm like, let me go. You scare him off. The chicken starts running. The rooster has to move in the room. Get a little walk on. You know what I'm talking about? Huh? Somebody, yes, right. Somebody have to teach you how to make it. Amen. Some of these old women can show you. I don't mean old women, but women who are older than you can show you how to get a man and hang on to a man. Once you get him, you kill him anyway. Once you get him, they're trying to get away from you. You don't know. They're trying to enjoy one Super Bowl day, and here you are. Get back to your notes, Pastor. Okay. So they got 1,000 friends on Facebook, you get unfriended, right? Strangles you. Now can we get it? Look at it. Guess how far you made it. You made it to about day 14. Mr. Temporary did what, 24 to 48? Huh? Mr. Next One did maybe 7. You went past that. You now up to 14 days. You stuck with it 14 days. Listen. Hear this, you stayed with it long enough to start experiencing the physical changes on the outside, but your habits hadn't changed on the inside. I just heard this, so I'm gonna throw this one out. You just got enough to move you in the direction of getting in the prom dress, but your lifestyle hadn't changed enough to stay in the dress.
What was that moo-moo? No, I ain't gonna mess with that.
About 2 weeks into the process, I heard moo-moo. I don't know who that was. You gotta pray. Are you with me? Thank you, brother. Thank you. Preach, Pastor! Yeah! I need to put him up on the pulpit, man. We're gonna rock it. I said, you got it? Yeah! Are you all hearing me today? Is this helping you?
Yes.
I know we're laughing, but this is serious. Because some of us are stuck right here, and the devil is rejoicing because he knows it's only on the surface with you. And then he's going to come along and shame you for all of the stuff you didn't do based upon what you heard. And then you'll start beating yourself up, the devil can walk away. You'll beat yourself up because your life hasn't gone anywhere for years. Listener number four. Anybody want to be listener number four? Man, if you got only four of them, I want to be number four. All the others been bad. You ready? Verse number 23. The seed cast on good earth is the person. Can you put your name in there? What is common about all of them? Did you notice that all of them heard something? Huh? The seed cast on the good earth is the person who what? He is and? Come on. Takes in the good news and then what? Produces it what, everybody? Beyond. Come on, it's what, everybody? Come on, wouldn't you like to have something beyond your wildest dream? I thought I'd get blessed, but Lord, blessed like that, oh my God. Anybody want that?
Yes.
Hallelujah, I want to declare it is mine. Come on, somebody declare, it is mine. I'm fighting for this. I'm going for this. It is mine in
Jesus' name.
How do you get it? How do you get it? You ready? This person is the one who hears. Somebody, come on, stay with me.
Yeah.
He hears. Somebody who also what?
Takes.
Come on. And they also produce. So you got to be a hearer. You got to be somebody who takes it in. And you have to be a what? So it doesn't matter if you hear and you take it in. Some of you have heard and taken in enough that you can write enough books to fill a library downtown. It'd be like a maze, man. You got stuff from 1901 right up to today, man. You got all kind of life, but you ain't producing nothing.
Right.
It's not like waiting to get a response on Twitter. Boom, you got it back that fast. No. The point is that you got to see yourself beyond the hearing and the taking and see yourself producing. And if you become a producer, what kind of harvest are you going to have? A harvest that is what, everybody? Come on, a harvest that is, oh my God, I just saw my harvest. A harvest that is what, everybody? Beyond your
wildest dreams.
Are you ready for this?
Yes.
We always say God is in charge, but guess what? According to this text, who's in charge? Because he's sowing. Yeah. And who's in charge of what happens to the seed? God will send the seed. God will send the rain. But it's up to me to put it to work. Amen?
Yeah.
So this is the person. You got to study the word. Anybody heard that scripture study? To show yourself what? Approved unto who? Come on. A God, a workman that won't be ashamed. Isn't that right? You got to learn how to think God's thoughts and get his wisdom in your brain and plant the seeds of life for your life.
Amen.
Now, it takes time for plants to grow. Are y'all still with me?
Yes.
So now you got to go beyond the 24 to 48. You got to go beyond the 3 days. You got to go past the 7 days. You got to go past the 14 days. You got to get to at least 21 days. Are y'all hearing me? And then, if you want to really get it deep, 21 days, I got to get my long-term memory. I got to go to God's thoughts, ways, and ideas. I got to go another 21 days and another 21 days. Listen, until I have 3 cycles of 21, and I want to build a habit. Let me say that. And when I build a habit, what is the reward? Woo! Huh? Come on, does anybody have any dreams? Y'all don't have any dreams?
Yes.
Man, I got some dreams. How do I get there? I got to do what?
I got to hear.
Thank you.
Take.
Uh-huh.
Produce.
How long?
21 days.
All right, I have to have 3 cycles of at least 21 to get the habit built. And then as a result of building the habit, what's going to happen? I'm going to produce. Now, what is the Bible telling me when it says I will produce a harvest? Is it telling me something about time? Do you have it? Yes, on your lesson, does it say a harvest takes what, everybody? Come on, a harvest does what, everybody? It takes what? Do you have time?
Yes.
Oh, yes, you do. I don't know if that was the Lord. I just heard you're just as dumb today as you were yesterday. But that wasn't the Lord. I'm sure he wouldn't say that about anybody, right? But you got time to work on no longer being dumb. I think that the second one was the Lord. I don't know about the first one. Amen. But time is going by anyway. Isn't that right?
Yes.
Come on. Time is going by. So 1 year from now, where do you want to be? 2 years from now, where do you want to be? 3 years from now, where do you want to be? 4 years, 5 years. Time is going to pass anyway. And if you're not planted, if you're not here, if you're not taking, if you're not producing, you will not be making anything. Are you hearing that?
Yes.
1 Corinthians chapter 2. We're done. 1 Corinthians chapter 2. Periscope, put this to work. Please, put this to work. 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verses 9 and 10. So that's why we have the scripture text. Do you see it?
Yes.
Huh? No one has ever what, anybody?
Seen.
No one has ever heard anything like this. Never so much as what, everybody? Imagine anything quite like this. What God has done, what?
Arranged.
Whoa, God has done what?
Arranged.
Have you ever arranged the furniture in your house?
Yeah.
That means everything is not everywhere.
Right.
Everything is in a certain place.
Right.
So God has arranged things. So if you walk with Him, amen, and you get to this place, and you get to that place, and you get to the third place, He's going to make sure you have a harvest that goes beyond your wildest dream. And the Bible says God has done what? Arranged it for you. Amen. He arranged it for those who love Him. But you've seen and heard it because God by His Spirit has done what? Brought it all out into the open before you. The Spirit, not content to flit around on the surface, what does it do? Dives into the depths of God and it brings out what? What God has been doing, what? Planning all along. Is God planning to bless you?
Yes.
Is God planning to prosper you?
Yes.
Is God planning to keep you?
Yes.
Is God planning to help you?
Yes.
Is God with you?
Yes.
Are you getting that and understanding that?
Yes.
Huh? Come on, are you getting it and understanding it?
Yes.
So now, which listener are you? Huh? Come on, which listener? Be honest, I know where I get jacked up. I know where I get jacked up. Where do you get jacked up? The 24 hour? The 48? Come on, the 7 days? The 14? The 21? Do you get the 3 cycles of 21? Amen. Okay, let's do it this way. Not only which one are you, which one do you want to be?
Okay.
Huh? So I need to know where I am, right? So I can know where I need to go. So I need to know which one I am. What do I struggle with? Where do I fall out of place? Where do I end up with the nothing? Where is the devil trying to keep me? So I will produce nothing. So I will stay discouraged. Which one of the listeners does he want me to be? Huh? Do you know all three of them can come to church? Oh yeah, they can all be in church. They can all have a good time in church. One of them gonna have more fun than everybody. Oh, hallelujah! And produce nothing. Are you getting that? So which listener do I want to be? Huh? God will help me do that. Amen? So Periscope, you're walking with me. You got your assignment. You know what to do. All of us here, we know what to do. Amen? We've been working on our thoughts. Pastor's been showing you. You got the material. You have so much stuff available for you. You have more stuff than I can give to you in a sermon. Amen? You can really do a PhD study on how to make your life better rather than flushing your life down the tubes year after year after year. Amen?
Amen?
Amen. And you can go to work on it. And if you do the stuff, what is your reward? According to the Bible, what is your reward? God is going to do what? Yeah, but not just the harvest. Man, if I plant a tomato and get a tomato back, now that's not what God is saying. What is He saying? I will get a harvest? What kind of harvest? Beyond, come on somebody, my
wild.
Woo! Anybody got any wild expectations?
Yes.
Anybody have a preference list?
Yes.
God is saying, I will do better than your preferences. I will go beyond your wild. Woo! I'll be saying, God, I didn't know you had a man that good for me. I didn't know you had a woman that good for me. I didn't know you had a job that good for me. I didn't know you had health that good for me. I didn't know you had joy like that for me. Anybody want that? Huh? Okay, we got one amen. Periscope, I've been working hard. I'm tired.
That one amen. That amen. That one amen can come through and be a blessing and a demonstration of the power of God. Get the rest of us moving forward. We know exactly what to do.
Yes,
Lord. Amen. Can you touch your neighbor? You say, you better get it done. Amen. Yeah. Come on, you better get it done. Don't leave your blessings hanging around. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. So we're going to say goodbye to you in just a moment on Periscope, YouTube. We're going to move into our first fruit miracle service. Stay with me for another moment. I'm going to talk about it. You on Periscope, on YouTube, go to our website, SOL Fellowship. I'm going to have somebody put it up. You can contribute there and be a part of this. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Thank the Lord. Thank the Lord. I know where I am. You know where you are. Amen? Amen. Amen. Listen. There are miracles to be released today and beyond. God has a system to prosper you spiritually, physically, and financially. God is the one who said, I'm not going to bless you with your dream. I'm going to bless you with something that's more than your
wow.
That's God's idea, right? But many of God's children are suffering because they don't cooperate with God's system. So you can have a whole lot of people in church shouting and getting happy with a temporary memory and when the emotions wear off, but when worry and envy comes in, they end up with nothing. We got to learn how to honor God, right? And step into what he has for us. Proverbs 3, 9 and 10, it says, honor the Lord with your wealth and with the best part of everything you produce. Then he will fill your barns with grain and your vats would overflow with new wine. Let's follow me. What is your thinking when you hear that? Because some of us, because our thinking is messed up, we immediately hear, God is after my money. No, what did God say? Honor me with your wealth. And then as a result of you honoring me with your wealth, with the best of everything you produce, then what will happen? Man, I'm going to fill things up. You're going to have an overflow in your life. So when God is telling me that, what is he trying to do? He's trying to make sure I am filled up and I have overflow.
Amen.
Honor the Lord with your wealth. You can honor God with your wealth, with the best you have. You can make God first. And then God will fill up the barns and overflow with new wine. You got a barn, you got a storage place, your vats would overflow. God is interested in continuous prosperity of his people. Listen, because there are continuous needs and things that can be done. Based on a person honoring God with their wealth, have we experienced it in the house? I told you the story before of the person who came, we were praying. They were making $5,000 a year, about $400 and some a month. And we knelt and we prayed because they didn't want to make just $400. Now, if you're comfortable with that, that's fine. Nobody's hitting on you, talking about you, degrading you, amen? Some people are comfortable where they are. If that's you, amen. But if you want more from God, is more available? Is something available beyond your wildest dream? Yes. And we prayed. They wanted to be able to give $50,000. Man, is that major? And in order for them to give that, they needed to make $500,000. Are you hearing me? I was sharing their testimony when they made it. Another person, remember the church, if I gave you the names of people, everything, you would know them. You're like, yeah. They prayed the prayer that day. They prayed. I didn't even know they're praying. They're saying, God, do for me what you're doing for them. And God moved in their finances, and this is what they're telling me. They said God blessed them with so much money, they didn't know what to do with. God busted their budget. Anybody know what he's talking about? You got everything covered in your budget. He gave them so much, they didn't know. They're writing checks to everybody. Are you hearing me? As a result of your giving today, we're going to give our tithe, we're going to give our offering, we're going to give a special blessing over and above that. Our first fruit offering. As a result of this, and you're going to have to hear this. As a result of this, we're going to declare a blessing over your life. a blessing of prosperity, a blessing of peace, a blessing of power. And then there's something you're going to do to produce the harvest. You're going to hear what I'm saying. You're going to take it in. And to produce the harvest, listen to me, you're going to fight in prayer. I'm asking you to take 30 days, whatever today's date is, for the next 30 days, you're going to fight in prayer at least 3 times a day. Let me give you scripture for this, because we miss this with a lot of things. Somebody comes and prophesies over your life. Do you know what happens? Now the devil knows what God is planning to do for you. And we're sitting up saying, oh, they prophesied over my life, it's going to happen. Rarely does the will of God happen. It's been prophesied over your life. What does the devil do? The 3 wise men came along and they saw the baby Jesus, right? That's when Herod, come on, y'all, he got busy, started killing babies. Because I know the Savior is in that area. And so word has been prophesied over you, and you haven't fought in prayer. You haven't become sensitive in prayer. So as we declare the blessing over you, that you will move into a place where your wild, beyond your wildest dreams will happen. As you receive that, the enemy is going to notice it, and you're going to have to pray your way through it. I'm asking you to pray at least 3 times a day. Huh? Call upon the Lord morning, noon, and night. Cry out. And the Lord will hear your voice. Now, Pastor, you're saying I need to pray 30 minutes a day. No, 3 times a day. It may be a short prayer, right? It may be a long prayer. How much time you have to pray. It may be a prayer. You may pray in the spirit. You may pray at your understanding. At least 3 times a day. You're going to be marking your day off morning, noon, and night for the next 30 days, contending for the blessing of the Lord to come upon your life. And some of you, the financial miracle will be as startling as somebody going from $5,000 in a year to being able to tithe $50,000. Startling. And then some of you will be just riding on the coattails saying, God, do for me what you did for them. And be at the place where God sends you a budget-busting download of blessing. It goes beyond your wildest dream. Because you hear it, you take it, and you start producing the harvest. You got it? So we understand spiritually what's about to happen. Are you clear about that?
Yes.
Because once the word has been released, you're going to contend for it. You're going to fight for it. And the Lord has put it very clearly in my heart. When I first heard it, I said, God, to release it on the 4th, it doesn't work for me numerically. It's better for me to start at 1 and go to 30. Because I don't have to remember anything. That's the way my mind works, amen. But if I start on the 4th, then I got to remember 30 days from there. I got to do all the, you know, anybody like that?
Yeah.
But 30 days, we're going to contend morning, noon, and night. You can pray more than that. But you're going to go before God. I can give you scripture if you need it. Psalm 55, 16, and 17. You can look at the story of Daniel and how he prayed and contended. Daniel 6, right? Mm-hmm. When they were contending with Daniel and set everything up. Right, he prayed. You remember they threw him in the lion's den? Because Daniel was praying morning, noon, and night. But God came along and did what? Shut the lion's mouth. Anybody want the lion's mouth shut?
Amen.
Amen. I want it shut. Amen.
Amen.
I want the experience. And the experience is going to happen for you. We're going to release it in just a moment. It's going to be manifested in your life. A manifestation of your offering, your blessing is going to take place in your life. But you're going to contend for it. Once it's declared over your life, you're going to fight and contend for it. Some of you have prophetic words that you have not contended in prayer and worship for the fulfillment of those words. That's where the devil has been fighting you. So it's been prophesied that your finances will be released. What does the devil do? He attacks your finances. It's been prophesied you will have a great relationship. What happens? The devil attacks you with relationships. It's been prophesied for you. So we're going to do what? Fight back.
Amen.
We're hitting him back. We're going to be persistent in our resistance. And the Bible says you resist him, he's going to run. And if I'm doing any running, I'm going to be chasing him to hit him again. Amen? Amen. We're going to declare that to be true. So get ready as you prepare to give. Get ready as you prepare to give. I believe they have special envelopes for first fruit offering. We're going to receive our regular tithe and offering. We're going to put that in the basket, your first fruit offering. Hold it in your hand so we can hold and pray over it. I don't need to see the amount and all of that. That's not the issue of it. You turn it over, all of that. I want to pray and declare God's will and power and grace. Those of you on Periscope, listen to me. If you participate in this, you participate in this, walk into the covering of the three times a day, morning, noon, and night. Whatever your morning is, whatever your night is, everybody know what noontime is, amen? Morning, noon, and night, you're going to pray. You're going to pray. You're going to declare. You're going to believe God. You're going to contend for what is prophesied over your life. And in Jesus' name, I declare over everyone on Periscope who's walking with us today, and you sense it's your time, then we step in there with you today and declare that to be true over your life as well. A harvest beyond your wildest dreams in Jesus' name. Amen, 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 amen. Goodbye. Talk to you later. Goodbye. Thank you for being there. Share this with your friends, your loved ones.